Hello everyone, we will start with the Beckmann rearrangement today. Beckmann rearrangement is conversion of oxime in presence of any acidic catalyst like PCl5 to N substituted amide. Okay. The catalyst what we can use other than PCl, normally we use PCl5, but other than PCl5 we can use concentrated H2SO4, we can use phosphoric acid, we can use formic acid, we can use thionyl chloride, etc. These are weaker acidic catalysts, and this H2SO4, PCl5, they are stronger acidic catalysts. So any one of these we can use. What is oxime? Oxime is obtained by the reaction of a carbonyl compound aldehyde or ketone with hydroxylamine. This is hydroxylamine, and after the reaction of this we get an OH, this compound, and this compound is known as oxime. If we use aldehyde, this is called aldoxime. If we use ketone, this is called ketoxime. Okay, so this is called hydroxylamine. This is derivative of ammonia. Okay, so when we take oxime and treat it with any one of the acidic catalyst, especially PCl5 or concentrated H2SO4, we get N substituted amide. Let us take an example. Suppose we have this compound, oxime of benzophenone. This is oxime of benzophenone. When it is treated with acidic catalyst, what happens? Key, one of the group which is just opposite to this OH group, for example here it is this, this migrates from here to here. Okay, the group which is just opposite to OH group, in spite of irrespective of the migrating aptitude of these two, the group which is just opposite to OH group will migrate from here to here, and a carbonyl group is generated at here. So finally what we get is C double bond O, N, H, and then this. Okay, this one is this group, okay, which is just NT2 OH group. Okay, that group will actually migrate irrespective of the migrating aptitude. Okay, how the mechanism proceeds, let us have a look on the mechanism. Okay, the oxime is treated with, this is the oxime, it is treated with the acid. The first step is that the H positive of the acid, it attacks on the OH group, the lone pair of the OH. Okay, so here are the lone pairs, so this H positive will attack over here, and we will get a compound C double bond N OH2. This is oxonium ion. Okay, after that, this oxonium ion is not stable because of presence of positive charge on the oxygen. So this group is removed in the form of water. Okay, this will be removed in the form of water, and migration of this alkyl group takes place from this carbon to this Electron deficient nitrogen. This is electron rich species and this is electron deficient species. So if electron donating groups are attached with this benzene ring, the reactivity of the Beckmann rearrangement will increase. It means if the migrating group has electron donating effect, the rate of Beckmann reagent will be increased. So after this we get water is removed from here, and after that we get C positive charge, double bond N, and here benzene ring. This phenyl group has been migrated over here, which is anti to this OH2. So the reaction is highly stereospecific. Okay, and the retention of configuration takes place. Configuration of this group is retained if it is chiral. Okay, so retention of configuration takes place if the migrating group is chiral. After that, the solvent attacks on this positively charged carbon. Solvent is water over here. So this water will attack on this positively charged carbon atom, and the compound, the species which is formed is COH2 positive, double bond N, and this is the second phenyl group. After that, there is removal of H positive from here. So H positive is removed and we again get the enol form OH, double bond N, and this. Okay, what we get is this. Okay. And this is further enolized. This enol form is converted into keto form. This will move here and this will move here. So ultimately we get C double bond O NH. This is N substituted amide. This is our product, N substituted amide. So this is the group which has been migrated from this carbon to this carbon, and this was NT to the OH. This group has migrated, which was NT to the OH. So this is the overall mechanism of Beckmann rearrangement. Now let us take few examples of Beckmann rearrangement. Examples. There is a compound CS. Okay. This compound, this oxime, is treated with H3PO4 heat, and this is the solvent, that is water. So when it is treated with H2PO4, what will happen? The Beckmann rearrangement will take place. This group is NT to the OH. So irrespective of the migrating aptitude, this will migrate over here and this carbon is converted into CO group. So what we will get? We'll get C double bond O, and this is CH3. Okay, and this group is changed into this. This will migrate on this nitrogen atom. So we will get this. We can write it properly. Okay. NH CO CH3. So finally, we will get this product. This is N substituted amide. Okay. Let us take another example. This is a compound. This is ketone. And when it is treated, this is cyclohexanone. When it is treated with NH2OH, This is hydroxylamine. So when it is treated with hydroxylamine, we get oxime and NH. Sorry, this ring will not be there. This is cyclohexyl group. And when this oxime is treated with acidic catalyst, say H positive H2SO4, what will happen? This will undergo Beckmann rearrangement. Double, this is NH and this OH will be protonated. And after this, this H2O will be removed. And the group which is empty to this OH2, this H2O will be removed. This is protonated and this H2O will be removed. And the group which is empty to this OH2, this is this bond. This will migrate, means this bond will be broken and this carbon will be attached to this NH, and we will get this bond will be broken and we will get NH C double bond O again. Okay, this will be converted into double bond O, and after that 1 2 3 4 5. So 1 2 3 4 5. Okay, this is a ring, 7-membered ring, in which there are 6 carbon atoms, and this is amide, N substituted amide. This is called caprolactam. This is called caprolactam. Okay, and this caprolactam is the monomer of a polymer called nylon 6. When it is treated with base, this caprolactam is converted into nylon 6. Okay, so this reaction is very important for the formation of caprolactam. Now, there is a modification in Beckmann rearrangement, and that is called Beckmann fragmentation. What is that? Beckmann fragmentation. What is Beckmann fragmentation? In oxime, this is the oxime, when any one of the alkyl group, either R or R dash, it is having the capacity, any one of it, it is having the capacity to form a more stable carbocation. More stable carbocation, then this bond is broken. Suppose this is having the capacity to form more stable carbocation, so this bond is broken, and this forms a more stable carbocation, and this group attached, here it is nitrogen, and this group, suppose this is going to form a more stable carbocation, so this bond is broken, here there is triple bond formation, and this hole is converted into nitrile. Let us take an example. This is an oxime. Okay, in this oxime, this is carbon, and these are the two groups which it attaches to the oxime. So these two substituted groups, they have tendency of migration. The group which is opposite to this OH should migrate, but here this can form a more stable carbocation. So when we treat it with acid H positive, what happens? It forms double bond N and OH2. Now, in spite of migration, this bond is broken and this will leave. So what will happen? A carbocation will be generated over here. because this can form a more stable carbocation. So what we get this will generate a carbocation, and this bond is broken, and this was this bond, and now this carbon triple bond N is formed. This is removed and we get carbon triple bond N. And then water attacks on it, or there is removal of proton and it is converted into alkene. No water attack takes place, and there is removal of proton and this is cyanide. There is removal of proton and we get alkene. Okay, minus H positive. So this is called Beckmann fragmentation. There is removal of proton. What happened? Carbocation was formed and this was converted into the cyanide. Now after that there is removal of proton, and proton will be removed from this or this. So a double bond is formed, and this is called Beckmann fragmentation. The Beckmann fragmentation, the Beckmann fragmentation is facilitated by presence of heteroatom. Presence of heteroatom. What are heteroatoms? Like oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur with lone pair on the beta carbon atom next to oxime. Suppose this is oxime N and this is OH. Okay. And with this carbon, two alkyl groups are attached. Okay. So this alkyl group and this alkyl group. If any one of this alkyl group has halogen attached with it, or nitrogen attached with it, oxygen, sulfur. So this atom which has lone pair, it facilitates the fragmentation. It donates its lone pair to this, and the fragmentation takes place very easily. Okay, when H positive will attack over here, this will be removed and fragmentation will take place very easily, and we will get C double bond X, okay, other groups, plus R C triple bond N. Suppose this is R, then RC triple bond N plus water. Okay, so the fragmentation is favored by the presence of heteroatom at the beta carbons. Okay, if aldoxime is treated in the Beckmann rearrangement, I told you that mainly this Beckmann rearrangement is used for the ketoxymes. But if aldoxime is treated, what happens? Okay, suppose this is an aldoxime, CH double bond N and then OH. Okay. So this is the aldoxime. When this one is treated with an acid catalyst, the Beckmann fragmentation actually takes place. What happens? Okay, this H and H positive is treated with this. What will happen? Okay, benzene ring. CH double bond N, and this is converted into OH2 positive. Now this is the ring. This H donates its electron to this and this is removed. So we get the Beckmann fragmentation, and we get nitrile actually. Okay, this is benzonitrile. What we get ultimately is nitrile with aldoxime. Okay, this was over. Thank you.